Albuquerque couple is speaking out tonight after their baby died while in CYFD custody this week. It's the same couple accused of burying their drowned one-year-old daughter in a shallow grave. News 13's Jeannie Nguyen is here tonight with that side of the story. Jeannie, what's happening?
Madeline, Monique Romero and David Zuber made headlines in January after police learned their infant daughter's body was buried in a Northeast Heights backyard. This week, their six-month-old son died while in CYFD custody, and the family says it's the state's fault.
They failed us big time.
Monique Romero and David Zuber were joined by family and attorneys this afternoon.
We really wanted to come out and just let you guys know our story because, you know, there's a lot of stipulation and all kinds of accusation.
This week, Albuquerque police say Romero and Zuber's six-month-old son was found unresponsive while in a CYFD foster home and later died. The family claims in the days leading up to the boy's death, they sent multiple complaints to CYFD about the foster family.
There was times where there was some marks on the baby or there was some type of they would have a diaper rash.
Zuber was clearly distraught as her uncle said the boy's death could have been prevented had CYFD allowed the couple's own family to foster the infant.
We feel discriminated and we feel judged, you know, and I understand the circumstance. We're not negligent on the circumstances of what's gone on here.
Back in December, police say the couple buried their one-year-old Anastasia Zuber in a home's backyard near Eubank and Manal after she drowned in a bathtub. The family did not mention Anastasia by name today, but acknowledged the case.
We had some unfortunate things happen, and we take full responsibility and accountability for that. But, you know, we're good people that take care of our children.
We tried to ask the family what responsibility they believe they bear for the deaths of both children.
Can we ask you a question?
No.
Off camera, the family's attorney agreed to answer our questions and says the couple feels responsible and they're getting help to cope. The press conference, called by the family, ended with this.
We want our privacy and give us time to heal and just back off.
Now, the family would not provide us with the copies of the written complaints they sent to CYFD, but said their complaints were that the baby had marks and rashes, along with poor hygiene. Madeline, back to you.
All right, thank you, Jeannie. In a statement to News 13, a governor spokesperson says CYFD continues to investigate this case and is committed to a child's well-being. They also say the foster family involved appreciates the support from CYFD.